FastHTML is using the look and feel of Pico CSS as default. It is both perfectly fine and a bit generic and bland. How can we spice up the styling of our web application when we are using FastHTML? The simplest way to change the look and feel from the default is to just change one HTML element. This could be one button or a background color of one specific item, or maybe spacing of a text. So let's try to change the background color on just one of the cards of our example application. Do note that by default, all card background colors are more or less black. But here we have made the background color of this form card being gray. And this is how it's done in code. And as suspected, it is just an extra argument to the card function. We are setting the CSS background color to the color gray. So this is the first way to do styling changes, and we call this inline styling. The second way to change styling in FastHTML is this one. And this one affects all elements of one type in the entire application. And for this example, I choose to alter the font from a normal one to a monospace one. Now, we do this by setting a style element in the HTML header section. And if we're looking at the code, this is entered as a list of CSS arguments that's put into a style function and given to the HDR attribute of the fast app call, as shown in this. And if we look at this one, we can see that all fonts in the entire application are now monospaced as we set in this setting. And we can compare it with the old one as well. So this second way of doing style changes is called class override styling. Then, for a third way, what if we want to leave Pico CSS behind? We can do that, but we need to do a bit more then. First, we need to tell Fast Application that we don't want it to set up Pico CSS at all. And we do that by setting the argument Pico equals false. But then we also need to give it another CSS source. And we do this by inserting a link into the header section as before. Now, in this example, I have downloaded the Pico CSS file and then just altered it to my own liking. And what I've done is to change the background color of every card in the entire application. And I put this in a file from the local directory called mypico.css. And if we look at the results of this one, yes, every background color is now gray. And this way of handling style changes is called replacement styling. And now for the bonus tip. If you have a bigger application, or perhaps you would like to provide your own CSS from a static file server or from a CDN network, you just need to replace the link that in the earlier example pointed to a local file sitting on the root directory, you can point that to any kind of file on the internet. Now, this works good for any kind of CSS file. If it comes from a CDN network, or if it comes from Tailwind, or if you have another CSS solution. Replacement styling can reach over the internet, wherever you choose to point it. And there we have it. We have three ways of styling our Fast applications. We can do it inline, just changing one component. We can do a class override and changing one class of elements in an entire application. Or we can do a total replacement, and that can be done with a local file or something sourced from the internet. So now that you know about CSS styling, it's time to start creating. Now, for the next video in this series about FastHTML, we will venture into doing dashboards using FastHTML. So to not miss out on any other FastHTML content, do subscribe. When the next video in this series is published, it will show up here, so just click it, and I'll see you there in just a second.